Finland's capital Helsinki lies on the country's southern coastline at the Gulf of Finland, opposite the Estonian capital Tallinn. Like is so often the case, the city is not only the political heart of the nation, but also plays an important economic, cultural and tourist role. Helsinki is no doubt gorgeous, with the historic city centre offering an abundance of monuments, and the harbour area also lending the city a very particular coastal ambience. And also the locals are very welcoming to visitors. With the exceptionally high proficiency in English in Finland, you can certainly communicate very easily. Adjacent to the airport lies a fascinating aviation museum, containing an abundance of famous, but sometimes also exquisitely rare types that have helped shape Finnish aviation history, both military and civilian. The exhibition is located in two themed hangars, with a small area in between for temporary exhibitions. In summer 2021, this temporary exhibition was dedicated to aircraft manufacturer Saab and the link to Finland. Aside from complete aircraft, the hangars also feature several complete cockpits and other exhibits such as an air traffic control center, Finnish model aircraft, and even some historic aviation toys. The Finnish Aviation Museum also had a promotion stand at Finland's largest air show of 2021, held at the southern end of the city in Kaivopuisto Park, overlooking the Gulf of Finland. The park was dotted with trade stands of participating displays, sponsors and the Finnish military. And with well over 600,000 people living in Helsinki, the event certainly drew a huge crowd. The air show took place on Friday, with Saturday seeing pilot interviews on the main stage and music performances, for instance by the Finnair Big Band. Among the ground attractions were also a few static aircraft, including a pair of NH-90 tactical transport helicopters belonging to the Finnish and German Army. Atop one of the hills, the German Navy showed off one of its Sea Lynx helicopters. Most of the display area was dedicated to the promotional stands of the manufacturers competing in the Finnish HX fighter contract to replace the F-18 Hornets. These included the stands of Dassault promoting the Rafale, a mock-up and presentation stand of the Eurofighter Typhoon, and further down the popular trade stand and mock-up, which was open to the public, of the Saab JAS-39 Gripen. Also present was Boeing, promoting the F-18 Super Hornet and Growler combo. And finally, Lockheed Martin with the F-35 Lightning II. This also with a mock-up open to visitors. The air show over the bay at Kaivopuisto Park was limited to Friday late afternoon and evening. At 4 p.m, this special formation entered the display box. The DC-3 from Air Veteran and operated by the DC-3 Association in Malmi, flanked by the Arctic Eagles display team. The Arctic Eagles are a Finnish display team that was founded in 2014 with 3 aircraft, with a 4th member joining in 2016. They followed in the footsteps of the Redbirds aerobatic display team. At Kaivopuisto in 2021, they performed a two-ship display that contained the formation elements of their regular four-ship routine, so close formation flying only and no solo aerobatics. In the lead, we see a Christian Eagle aerobatics aircraft with a rare Pitts Model 12 on its wing. The Christian Eagle is flown by Miki Ratakora, a captain with Finnair. The Christian Eagle is a powerful biplane that has helped countless pilots master aerobatics. And here we see the usual Eagle 3 and Eagle 4 performing a break. Here we see the VL Viima, a Finnish-built biplane training aircraft from the 1930s. This type first flew in 1936, but it served with the Finnish Air Force until the 1960s. Its manufacturer VL was absorbed by Valmet following the Second World War, so the type is often referred to as the Valmet Viima as a result. In the 1950s, the Viimas were fitted with canopy frames, but this one is the only airworthy one out of 24 built in the condition from the 1930s and 40s, including its original color scheme. For the time, it had quite a good range, with 500 kilometers, and with a cruising speed of about 90 knots, it is also an interesting airshow performer, being able to keep it close to the crowd. Flying the aircraft gracefully here, in some trying windy conditions during his display, is Sami Saikkonen, an accomplished aerobatics pilot with experience on countless types. And with this friendly wave, Sami makes place for the next classic aircraft act. Here we see Phil Lawton flying a Yak 11. The aircraft is stationed at Espoo in Finland. It was built in Czechoslovakia as a C-11 back in the 1940s by the company LET and arrived in Finland in 2017. The Yak 11 was a popular training aircraft with several air forces in the former Warsaw Pact. It was based on the Yak 3 fighter aircraft from the Second World War, but it came with an improved engine. Despite being a trainer, it did see combat service with the North Koreans. The East German Air Force also used it to intercept American reconnaissance balloons. Moving away from classic military aircraft, we see one of the leading aerobatics aircraft of the modern day, the Extra 330LX, presented here by Hari Kanto. The Extra 330 is a further development of the renowned Extra 300 family of aircraft by German designer and manufacturer Walter Extra. The LX is a two-seat variant which can be used for training or aerobatic experience flights. It makes extensive use of carbon fiber to help keep the weight down, and its Lycoming engine with 315 horsepower gives it ample power for even the most challenging aerobatics routines, add 2 fuel pumps and it can certainly cope with any flight situation. It is certified to go up to plus or negative 10 Gs. Whether the pilot can handle such forces is of course an entirely different matter. Harikanto is part of the Finnish Aerobatic Championship team and has taken part to represent his country in several international competitions. The protection of over 2,500 kilometers of land borders and a long coastline is the task of the Finnish Border Guard, subordinate to the Ministry of Interior and the President of Finland in the capacity of the military's commander-in-chief. It has police and investigative powers, but also has a search and rescue mission. They operate several aircraft types, including two of these Dornier 228 maritime patrol aircraft, though this type is due to be replaced. The Border Guard is not supposed to be used for the keeping of public order under normal circumstances, but it has two readiness platoons that can be used to support the police in exceptional situations, in matters of crowd control and internal security. The Dornier 228 is a twin turboprop Stahl utility aircraft that entered service in the 1980s. Finnish Border Guard also operate 5 Super Puma helicopters, this one giving a winching demonstration on 2 of the Border Guard's patrol vessels at either end of the display line. Aside from the Super Puma, the Finnish Border Guards also operate the Augusta Westland 8W119 and Bell 412 helicopters. These can also be used to assist local firefighters in their operations. Incidentally, the vessel you see behind this Watercat 1300 patrol boat of the Finnish Border Guard was the location from which the display director Perttu Karivalo monitored the action at the show. A dramatic drop in noise level came with this Phenom 100 of the Finnish Aviation Academy. This product of the Brazilian manufacturer Embraer is a popular training aircraft for airline crews around the world, perhaps most famously so at the Emirates Academy in Dubai. while the Phenom went through its routine, this Cessna 206G landed from the side of the display area and docked at the pier of the island opposite the crowd line. The Finnish Aviation Academy is a private company owned by the state of Finland, Finnair, and the city of Pori, where they are also based. Next in the display came the Finnish organization Navy Wings with their SNJ-3, the US Navy version of the T-6 Texan. This particular aircraft was built in 1942 and deployed to Wharton in the UK, but it transferred back to Pensacola in the USA to serve with the Air-to-Air Gunnery Training Squadron there. This individual aircraft has been flown by many fighter aces, of which perhaps most famous is Gregory Poppy Boyington, who gained fame in the Pacific on F-4U Corsairs. In 1946, it moved to Paraguay and later to Argentina. Flying the aircraft here is aerobatics pilot Petteri Tarma, who is also a captain on A350 with Finnair. The Woikoski Safir Squadron fly four Saab 91 training aircraft that formerly flew with the Finnish Air Force. The Finnish Air Force had 36 Saab Safirs in use until the late 1960s. This is a young team that was founded in 2017. A very different Saab classic is this B-17, a reconnaissance plane and dive bomber. 326 of these machines were built between 1941 and 1944, and they served with the air forces of Sweden, Denmark, and the Imperial Ethiopian Air Force. It was the first all-metal stressed skin aircraft developed in Sweden. It could be fitted with wheels or skis, which retracted backwards into the wings. When equipped with wheels, the large gear doors would act as dive brakes. Two Saab B-17s flew in Finland as target tugs, a task another Saab 17 also performed with the Austrian military. This particular example is flown by Johan Sjöstrand from Saab. From classic Saabs, we come right up to date to the newest Saab combat aircraft, seen here in its latest version, the Saab JAS-39 Gripen-E variant. At the controls during this performance is Saab test pilot André Brandström, because indeed, this is a company prototype. The Gripen-E was competing in a Finnish HX fighter contract at the time, in a bid to replace the Finnish F-18s. Sadly, the type was not chosen to continue the long relationship Finland has with neighboring Sweden's Saab. Compared to the older Gripen-C we'll see in action later, the E version has a more powerful General Electric F414 engine, a Raven ES-05 AESA radar, increased fuel capacity and a higher payload, which can be slung on two additional hardpoints, and more modern avionics. When the Gripen pushes negative G here, watch how it performs a torching, with the excess fuel nozzle dumping kerosene into the afterburner. The Gripen-E variant has already been ordered by Sweden and Brazil. Here we see Major Lanos and seven of his mates coming by, who together form the 2021 Patrouille de France. They were the undisputed stars of the show, in support of Dassault's pitch of the Rafale, which we'll see in action later. Have had many displays in 2020, but they used that time very well, redesigning the already superb routine and refining it further to the polished spectacle they presented in 2021, putting a new twist on some old favorites. That simultaneous aileron roll in formation, now aimed at the crowd, is just one example. They wrap up the first half of their display, the ribbon, with this spine-tingling break. This is the start of the even more dynamic second part of their performance, including the spectacular crosses. It is perhaps a little difficult to make out here, but on the tails of their patriotically colored Alpha Jet training aircraft, they wore a drawing of the character Petit Prince, a creation of the French aviator and author Antoine de Saint-Exupéry, to celebrate the 75th anniversary of its publication. one feature of the Kaivari Airshow that is perhaps even more striking during this performance of the Patrouille de France than during other displays is the absence of a public address system along the crowd line. To hear the commentary, the crowd were asked to rely on the 4G of their smartphones and to connect to a live broadcast of the commentary. It is also very noticeable from the audio here that the wind had died down after 6 p.m. compared to earlier in the flying display. Following this revamped final break, the team came by one last time drawing the Finnish national colors over the Helsinki coast. As mentioned, the Patrouille de France came to the show in support of the French company Dassault, who were there to promote their bid for the HX fighter contract, the Rafale. The Rafale took its time, but has achieved several export successes in recent times. It has now seen foreign orders from Egypt, India, Qatar, Greece, Croatia, and most recently, the United Arab Emirates. Flying the aircraft here is the 2021 display pilot Jérôme Toul from the airbase at Saint-Dizier. The aircraft is wearing a pretty paint scheme, inspired by the French Air and Space Force logo. The power provided by the two Snecma M88 turbofans, coupled with the advanced fly-by-wire system and the canards at the front, create a unique combination, giving the Rafale exceptional performance, as you can see in this display. Sadly, the Rafale was another unsuccessful contender in the Finnish HX program. At the show then got to see a rare occasion, an air display abroad by a German Army NH-90 tactical transport helicopter. Unfortunately, German displays are very rare outside Germany, so seeing this heavy helicopter put through its paces over the seafront was very welcome. NH-90 has earned a somewhat questionable reputation with low serviceability and high operating costs, which have led to its early withdrawal in several countries. The German Army operates 80 TTH variants, with two more on order. This is the same NH-90 that joined the static display in the park on Saturday, where the crews enthusiastically chatted with the audience. Another rare sight was this Finnish Air Force Hawk solo display, still sporting the celebratory special livery from 2020, when they celebrated the 40th anniversary of the Hawk in Finnish service. Demonstrating the aircraft's agility here is Captain Samsa Kaikkonen, a flight instructor at the Air Force Academy's 41st Squadron at Tikkakoski Air Base in central Finland. In January 1978, Britain and Finland announced a deal in which the Finnish Air Force was to receive 50 Hawk Mark 51s in 1980. The Finnish Air Force was limited to 60 frontline fighter aircraft by the Paris Treaty of 1947. Hawks were classed as trainers rather than fighters, but thanks to their ability to be armed, the Finnish Air Force capacity could be increased while continuing treaty compliance. In the 1990s, 7 additional Hawks were acquired to make up for lost airframes. In 2007, Finland also purchased 18 used Mark 66s from the Swiss Air Force. will see more Finnish Air Force Hawks at the end of this program. Eurofighter also made a considerable sales push at the 2021 Kaivari Airshow to win the HX contract, but alas, that was also not to be. Here we see Flight Lieutenant James Sainty from RAF Coningsby present the RAF solo display on a regular Typhoon, not the more usual blackjack display aircraft painted for the 2021 airshow season. Typhoon is a cooperation between Spain, Italy, Germany and the United Kingdom. Apart from these countries, it is also operated by Kuwait, Qatar, Saudi Arabia, Oman and Austria. You'll also notice that just like Rafale and Gripen, Typhoon relies on canards to give it additional agility, something that is shown to great effect in this display. Just like the other three European contenders in the HX competition we've seen, Typhoon has also been used in combat already. Following the Typhoon's performance, it joined up with three more, one RAF aircraft and two German Air Force Typhoons for two special flypasts for the occasion. A display that has been seen outside Finnish borders a few times in recent years and has even won awards is the Finnish Army NH-90. 20 NH-90s are in service with the Finnish Army Aviation, which replaced the Soviet-built Mi-8s since 2008. They are part of the Uti Jaeger Regiment, based at Uti in southern Finland, not far from Helsinki. As part of its display, the NH-90 fired flares, which are used in combat to lure heat-seeking missiles away from the aircraft engine's heat, and at air shows provides extra excitement and color for the audience. Following some closing action and away from the crew to the crowd, the NH-90 leaves the display area. This is the JAS-39 Gripen-C of the neighboring Swedish Air Force, flown by Peter Fallon, callsign Starbutt. Part of F-7 wing at Sotenas and has been the Swedish Air Force's display pilot since 2012, and as a result has gained lots of valuable experience which he has shared with his colleague display pilots at the annual Fast Jet Demo Pilot Seminar at the European Airshow Council, where they can openly share best practices, all with the aim of improving quality and safety of air displays. The 2021 was his final year to fly the Swedish Air Force Gripen solo display, but he aims to continue flying the aircraft for many years to come. Finland and Sweden are quite closely linked, with most official signs in Finland being bilingual, Finnish and Swedish. The Saab JAS-39 Gripens entered service with the Swedish Air Force in the 1990s and replaced the Saab 37 Viggen. In all, the Swedish Air Force ordered 204 Gripens, 8 of which took part in operations over Libya in 2011. Now you have heard a few times about the unsuccessful bids for the HX fighter contract. Here is the aircraft that eventually won that contract, the Lockheed Martin F-35 Lightning II. This F-35 made a few flypasses courtesy of the Italian Air Force, who were taking part in the Baltic Air Policing mission in summer of 2021. The F-35 has been the aircraft of choice for quite a few European air forces to replace their aging fighter fleets. It is a low observable or stealth aircraft and boasts a host of technological gadgetry. Delivery of the 64 Finnish F-35s will start from 2025, with training taking place in the USA. The first aircraft are expected in Finland from 2026. With the final deliveries and full F-18 fleet replacement around 2030. And here's the aircraft the F-35 will eventually replace in Finland, the F-18C Hornet. Like the NH-90 and Saab Gripen, it fired a lot of flares. Not that this superb display needs any extra bells and whistles to make it even more exciting. Flying the aircraft here is Captain Anssi Nieminen. The Finnish Air Force has won multiple awards across Europe with this spectacular display, showing off the stunning agility to great effect. This agility comes in part from the upgrade of the fly-by-wire flight control system, giving it a performance similar to the more modern Super Hornet, one of the contenders to replace the F-18 with the Finnish Air Force. For the F-18, Finland used to operate a mix of Western and Soviet types. The order for 62 F-18s in the 1990s was a break with that tradition, and it caused quite a controversy at the time. Closing the show was the Finnish Air Force aerobatic team Midnight Hawks, flying four BAE Systems Hawk Mark 51 training aircraft. Just like the solo display pilot, all team members are flight instructors at the Finnish Air Force Academy at Tikkakoski and not full-time display pilots, like some of the major Air Force teams on the European Airshow circuit. Team present a mix of close formation aerobatics and coordinated, synchronized aerobatic maneuvers. They take their name from the Finnish tradition to organize an air show around the summer solstice time, when they perform their routine at midnight, as the sun doesn't set that far north then. Surely they provided a fitting end to a memorable airshow on the Helsinki seafront. This was surely a show that will be remembered fondly for a long time.